¡Hola!
¡Hola!
Bienvenidos a LightSpeed Spanish.
Bienvenidos.
This video is going out to anyone who's thinking about attending one of our immersion courses or you already booked on.
It's too late for you.
Yeah, those people who paid the money, that's it. Doesn't matter what we say, you're coming. Okay. We want to, first of all, we want to apologize on behalf of Anna. Anna wanted to be here as well because Anna actually works on the immersion courses with us. But it just, we haven't been able to do that. So we'll do another video later on with Anna. But in the meantime, we wanted to get this video out for everybody. There are some things that we want you to take into account when you are thinking about attending or when you are due to attend one of our courses, okay? First thing. The course itself will not be easy for you.
First one.
Okay. No, but let's get the worst first. The worst first. Yeah, the second best. The course won't. The course is designed to be a challenge for you. It will be a challenge. And the main reason that it's a challenge is that all the lessons are...
in Spanish.
In Spanish. Okay. Now, what maybe we've explained ourselves badly in the past, and if we have, I apologize about that. But basically, every single class, whether you're a beginner or whether you're advanced, every class that we give is in Spanish. Okay? Now, what that means for you is it's the best news that you could possibly have. Why?
Exactly, why?
Why?
We want to know.
We want to know. Do you want to know? Why? Because if you want a class in English, you can stay in England and you can pay your fees and go to a class. And that's not what this is about. The word immersion is getting
yourself in Spanish.
Up to your neck and beyond. Yes. Yeah. So what happens is this. When you come, we now are organizing our classes into groups of beginners, groups of intermediate and groups of that, the advanced intermediate. Okay. That isn't because the class is going to be easier. I mean, there'll be elements of grammar which we won't give the imperfect subjunctive to the beginners, clearly. Yeah?
Not on the first day.
Not on the first day, anyway. Yeah. But the class itself will be in Spanish. The only reason that we're clubbing people together is that they'll feel a little bit more kind of with the peers. You know, beginners feel very intimidated by having advanced people in the class, and I understand that. Yeah? So that's the only reason why we're doing
it. We've had different courses where people have said different things, and some beginners like to be with intermediate or advanced because they helped them. Mm-hmm. And other times they wanted to be just with beginners because they thought it was going to be easier that way, maybe.
Sure, sure.
But the thing is, the way we run the courses is every class, every day that we have a class, we do a little bit of grammar. Well, Gon does the grammar, actually.
I do the grammar, yeah.
He's the grammar master. And then Anna and myself do different things. We do games, we do chats, we do reading, you know. So it's a bit of everything. It's not just grammar.
Sure.
So the grammar is just there, like, as a reminder and, or questions and things like that. But the good thing is that on Monday you're so overwhelmed by so much Spanish that by Tuesday or Wednesday the latest, you can't give a monkeys anymore. You're tired of these being overwhelmed.
Being stressed, yeah.
So that's when you start to really, really enjoy, when you just let go and when you start to speak
and make understand what you're hearing as well.
Yeah, you're more relaxed because now you know where you are. You've made yourself, what's the verb?
Comfortable.
Comfortable with the surroundings. Okay, yeah. Now you know Torrejón a little bit better.
Sure.
You know us a little bit better. You know more or less how it's going to be. Mm-hmm. And then you let yourself go, and that's when you really have fun. Mm-hmm. And that's what we've seen in every single course so far. By Tuesday evening, Wednesday, everybody's
changed
completely.
Energy, isn't it? Yeah.
So be aware that when you get there on Monday or Sunday, because we see most people on Sunday, you're going to be nervous. Everybody's nervous because it's like the first day, it's like, oh, we don't know each other. Okay. Mm-hmm. But we're all there, apart from learning, okay, we're there to have fun. Mm-hmm. We're there to make friends. We're there to have to make memories to last for a lifetime. Sure. Sure. Okay, so it's not just, oh, I'm going to be put in the spot. It's not about putting you in the spot. We don't want to put you in the spot. We want everybody to participate, help each other, learn from each other. Maybe you know something the other person doesn't know, mm-hmm. and the other way around. Mm-hmm. So we're all in that together.
Sure.
Okay?
Sure.
But it is in Spanish. Uh-huh. Everything's in Spanish. So mm-hmm. yeah, on Monday it's a little bit uncomfortable, but as the week goes by, you feel much more confident and comfortable with everything.
Mm-hmm. And by Friday,
the
quietest person on the Monday is a chatterbox on the Friday in Spanish.
Yeah.
One thing I'd say that's very important, just to add on to what Cynthia's saying, you're only there for a week. You are not really there to learn Spanish. That's mm-hmm. not what the purpose of the week is. What you're there to do is to take all the learning that you already have and bring it out. Okay, yes, you're going to learn stuff. You're going to learn a lot of stuff, but that's more like an addition. What we want you to do is we're going to put you under such pressure, and that's not a negative word, pressure to force the words out and to force your understanding, that it's going to happen. Everything that you know, you're actually going to start to be able to use. And,
yeah.
and everything that you know in terms of words, you're going to start to hear and pick up. Okay, so it's kind of that the week is really getting you into a place where everything you've got inside suddenly comes to life.
And confidence. And when you have more confidence.
Yeah.
Because we've had lots of feedback from people after the course saying, I stayed in Spain for another week, and now I feel really confident of going shopping and asking questions mm-hmm. because they've been put through everything.
Yeah.
So by Friday, they're like, go to the shop and ask for whatever. Yeah. Or mm-hmm. ask for a coffee. Whatever. Like,
yeah.
No problem whatsoever. So they feel much more confident. And even if they're beginners and they think, well, they might say things I don't understand, they know then what to say so they get across and...
Sure. Yeah. And another spin-off is that we started this, 3 years ago? 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
People in the very first groups, because we make WhatsApp groups for the team, still talk.
Yeah.
Some groups are meeting up.
Yeah.
Going to Ireland and meeting up, or in the UK and meeting up for a drink every now and again. And so not only do you have the benefit of the Spanish, but you also have this tremendous community that gets formed as well.
Yeah, and there are people from all over the place. We've had people from Japan. We've had people from Holland, from Australia, from New Zealand, from Canada.
This time from Iceland.
From Iceland this time, from America, from Britain.
Canada.
Lots of places. It's not just British people.
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-huh. Everywhere, people from everywhere. Mm-hmm. From Hungary.
Hungary, yeah.
From Hungary as well.
Yeah.
So you're going to make friends from all over the world.
Okay, so that's basically it. What we want you to do is expect it to be tough, but roll with it. Just trust the process. We have designed this to make sure we both learned a second language. We know what you need. And we have set up the process to get you to get the best benefit out of the week, but you must trust it. If you say, no, I can't do it, okay, you don't have to. Nothing's obligatory. You just won't get as much benefit out of it. Whereas if you just surrender, as Cynthia said, surrender yourself to the process and just let it happen and go through it, you'll get to the end of the week and you will be a new person. In terms of Spanish, you'll have a new outlook, you'll have a new confidence, and you'll have a new level of Spanish. And that's our promise. Yeah. Why can we promise that? Because we've seen it for 3 years without fail. Without fail.
And when people feel a little bit stressed, we always say, right, take it easy and just stay until Wednesday.
Yeah.
And that's it. And then they're fantastic. By Wednesday,
you've had a few drinks, you've made a few friends, you've been able to order a whiskey and coke.
Yeah, well, the whole day's in Spanish. It's not just the academy where we do the lessons. You have activities afterwards. And then you have the dinner with people coming and talk to you. Not you personally, as a group. You can participate in the conversation or just listen in or...
We have five or six native speakers coming after the evening meal, and they sit and chat with you.
So from the morning you get up until you go to bed, everything's in Spanish.
Mm-hmm. if you don't want to talk, listen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It doesn't matter. Your mind's working. Yeah. And so you're going to get tremendous benefit out of it. So there you are. Come and join us. You're going to have loads of fun. You're going to make your Spanish fantastic. And you're going to make friends for life.
And you meet Gordon as well.
True. Very true. And Cynthia.
And maybe Douglas.
And that, yeah. Possibly the dogs.
Yeah. My family comes over on Fridays most times, don't they? Mm-hmm. To say hello.
Yeah. Okay. Well. So that's it. We'll see you on one of our courses. And if you're coming on this course this year, be excited. Okay. It's going to be fun. Hasta luego.
Adios.
Adios.